What's going on, everybody? This is Joe.
And Amy.
And we are back with another episode of The Walking Dead. Last time, some stuff went down. I should say at the beginning of these, if you haven't watched the last couple of episodes, you should. You should watch all of it, obviously, but specifically the last couple, things are ramping up, and I would hate for this little recap at the beginning to be all that you get. I highly encourage you to go check them out, because they're very good. So maybe go pause this, go watch those, and then come back here. We would love to have you, but you should go check those out first. But for those of you that just don't remember or want a refresher or are okay with spoilers, last time we finally found Clementine again. Mm-hmm. We saved her from the man who had kidnapped her. He was the game called him the Stranger because we still didn't know his name.
Right.
But
we still never learned it before we killed him.
Nope. But he's the guy from the station wagon who our group stole from at the beginning of the game.
Right.
In this particular game, we chose not to willingly join in on that theft.
Right.
And then he had been following us really ever since. Although somehow he got ahead of us because he claimed that he was already in Savannah when talking on the radio when we got closer.
Well, I'm sure that Clementine told him that that's where her parents were.
Oh, and he had his car. So he probably just drove while we took the train or were like waffling around.
He went back to the car and saw that all the stuff was missing, but his car was still there.
Right. And if you notice, when we got to the hotel, the car was out front.
Yeah.
Remember I mentioned a little station wagon.
Right. And
so,
I was
like,
oh, a car.
Yeah. Right. So he drove there himself, it seems. So that's, I guess, how he got ahead of us. But anyway, we saved her. We killed him. And then we covered Clementine in zombie gook and to allow us to walk through the streets. So let's see how that goes for us.
Yeah.
Because we also, by the way, are
we are impervious to new bites, as we have already been bitten.
Correct. All right. Yeah, and we're starting to smell like them, so they don't they don't like us anymore.
Yeah, they don't find us appetizing.
Yeah. So here
we
go.
Hopefully we can shield Clementine well enough with our bodies and muck.
And the gore that's already on her that she just loved having on her. Poor girl. All right, let's see how this one goes. Sure is.
Whether without being covered in muck.
It sure is. Oh, it's going to make me do this walking. Oh, it's not. It won't even let me go side to side. I just have to walk forward.
Oh, they're like stopping to let us through, kind of.
Yeah. Or at least not walking into us. I mean, they don't really walk into each other either.
Right.
Like, so it makes sense.
I'm not saying that they're, like, purposefully, like, clearing space for us. I just mean, like, for purposes of us moving forward in the game.
Sure.
It's, like, keeping them from, like, moving.
See, that guy bumped into me.
But yeah.
She looks terrified.
Yeah.
I don't blame her. I would be pretty terrified.
Yeah,
and I'm not an
nine.
I was going to say, I'm not a 9-year-old girl.
Right.
And again, not
she
because
saw a duck get bitten,
right,
and then he had to die. And
come on, Clem.
What did she say? Is that her parents? Oh, it's Katya.
No, it's not.
It looks like Katya.
Don't look. Don't go over there. Don't stop moving.
Don't look. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. Molly.
Lee, wake up! Please don't be dead. Please, no! Lee, I was so scared. I thought you left me. I saw my parents.
It was her parents. I know. Come here. It's a good thing.
I know.
I know. They didn't get to you, right?
No. We got away. They're dead, for sure.
Poor
but
kid.
I'm glad you found them.
Kind of.
Clementine, we have to get out of here as fast as we can.
Well, we can't. There's thousands of them outside.
We have to. I'll protect you. We'll push through.
No, that's crazy. I saved you. We're safe here. I locked us in.
Get that door open.
I can't.
Do it!
Don't be mad at her.
He's scared.
It was only a little open when I found
it. He's running out of
time. I closed it to keep us safe.
He doesn't want to turn and kill, have be the one to kill her.
Yeah. One, two, three.
Come on.
Always with her fucking one arm.
Yep.
You have to do all this shit. We're so weak.
See?
Clementine, honey. My arm is gone because I cut it off.
Why would you do that?
Because I was bitten, Clem.
Please, no. No. That's not true.
Yes, it is.
It's gonna be okay. I'm sorry. There's no time to be upset.
It's gonna be okay.
It's gonna be okay. You are gonna be okay. We just have to think and work together.
Okay.
Yeah, we have to get this door open and get you back to Omid and Krista. That's all we gotta do.
I think there might be a way out over there.
Yeah, through that guy.
What the hell?
Are you serious?
Why is he just sitting there?
He's just Let's chilling go. In that chair.
I might be a little slow.
I'll help you.
Oh, God. Okay. Well, we can't...
This is gonna be fucking awful.
Yeah, we can't click on anything, but we can walk kind of, you know, stumble forward.
Oh, God. Poor Clem.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Yeah.
Oh. I got you. You can lean on me if you have to.
I'm okay. I'm okay.
I thought I was helping by bringing you in here.
You did.
You couldn't have known. You did. It's awful out there.
You did. It's awful out there.
Oh, you did, honey. It's awful out there. But they wanted to chew me up.
It was hard.
I don't know how you did. But you did good. Okay?
Keep going. We're almost there.
Still nothing to click on? No. Okay. Just walking forward.
Just walking forward.
You know, just walking forward.
Get up, Lee! The door is right here!
Oh, God. Come on, dude.
I can't.
You have to!
Liam, I can't move. This is it for me here.
Please, what? Please, try to get up!
Alone. Come on. Come on, Lee. Come on, brother.
Man.
You got it.
Fuck.
I can't. You don't have much time. You gotta do something. Fast.
Like what?
You need to get out of here. Keep away from me. You have to make sure I don't turn.
How? You need to get out of here.
You need to get out of here as soon as you can.
That was the last possible
I can't leave you.
Just work on getting out, okay? We'll figure it all out. Don't worry.
Okay. Oh, man.
Look at the office door. Look at the chair. Talk to her. Grab the baseball bat.
Grab the baseball.
Or, like, open the door.
Oh. Can she just open the door? Or?
I mean, there's a zombie in there.
So grab the baseball bat first.
Okay.
There's a baseball bat under the counter, Clem. You can use that.
Okay.
So we can smash the door. Or we can look at the chair.
Just try to open her. The door and
well,
then...
Well, no. Open the door is now no longer an option.
Oh, fine. Smash the door.
Use the bat to shatter that window so you can reach in, okay?
Okay.
Watch out for broken glass. Good job. Don't be afraid of him, honey. You're smart. He isn't. You're smarter than all of them.
That's true. So we could talk to her, we could look at the door, or look at the chair and move it.
Yeah, tell her to move the chair
grab
over.
The chair clip. Use it to reach in to the lock.
Okay, tell her to pick up the bat so she can hit him in the head when she goes in.
Nope.
What?
Not selectable.
Okay.
Open.
Looks like he's somehow stuck in that chair.
He's trapped.
Yeah.
This will be easy then. He's got keys. Probably to that door. And everything you'll need.
Okay. So there's handcuffs on the floor. And then there's the walker.
Handcuffs? Why would we need handcuffs?
To cuff this dude, I assume.
Is that gonna be doable?
I mean...
Okay, I guess we can try that.
There are handcuffs on the ground. Get them.
Okay, Lee.
She's gonna cuff Lee to the
Yep,
lady.
It wasn't to handcuff him at all. Alright, so we talk to her, we tell her to handcuff the walker, and we tell her to handcuff us.
Handcuff us.
Put the handcuffs on me. Attach me to this.
What? Why?
No matter what happens, I'm safe then.
I don't know.
Just do it, sweetie. Make sure they're tight.
I don't want to do this.
You have to. It'll keep you safe. You only have to deal with him.
Okay.
He's trapped over there. If you're careful, you can get what you need from him.
I can barely hear us.
And then the gun.
Over the deer.
Keys and the gun. Just don't be afraid. If anything gets dangerous, you're faster than he is.
What should I get first?
The gun.
Gun, keys, or both?
Gun first, keys second.
Always the gun.
Come on, girl.
You can do this.
Grab it!
Oh. Okay. That's good, that's good, that's good, that's good.
Watch out!
That's good, that's good, that's good. Good, good, good. Oh, gosh. What?
The bat clip. Get the bat.
Nope, I was supposed to grab it and kick it. Good girl. Yes. Great Clem, come here. You can take care of yourself.
Great Clem.
Great Clem. Good job.
Man. Fuck.
Hey.
I might turn. You're not safe or you're strong.
You're strong.
You're strong, Clem. You can do anything.
But I'm little.
That mean nothing. You go see bad stuff, but it's okay.
My parents. It's so horrible.
I can't imagine, Sweet Pea.
And now, you? Please. Please don't be one of them. Please don't become a walker.
There's only one thing you can do. You know that.
I don't know if I can.
You have to, or leave me.
Leave me.
You can leave me. It's okay.
You'll be just like them.
It's okay. It won't be me. It's time to go. You gotta get out of here.
You can come with me.
No, honey. I can't. It's okay.
Please.
You have to go. Now.
Maybe I shouldn't let you turn.
I don't want you to have to do that.
Shooting people changes you. Save the bullet or the noise?
Save the bullet.
Save the bullet. I'm not going anywhere. You have to always think about what you might need later.
Yes, you do.
Like Larry, honey. He was going one way or another, but at that moment I couldn't do more violence. You have to be careful about that. It'll consume you.
I'll go. I'll leave you. I'll go as fast as I can.
And as safe as you can. Always be safe.
Find Omid and Krista. Don't trust anybody or find a group.
Find Omid and Krista.
Find Omid and Krista. They're probably looking for us right now. Stay on high ground. Don't go too far. You'll find them. They'll take good care of you. And Clem.
Stay away from cities, always keep moving, or keep that hair short.
Always keep moving.
And always keep moving. You're gonna want to find some place like the motor inn, but that's just not safe.
Why not?
Those places are just targets. Move as much as you can. And also...
What is it?
No, don't worry. All right.
I'll miss you. Don't be afraid or you'll be okay.
Don't be afraid.
Don't be afraid.
It's always nice playing like a nice feel-good game, you know?
God damn.
Okay. Achievement unlocked.
I'm sorry, guys.
Achievement unlocked. What remains? And here are our percentages for this chapter.
Just give me a minute.
Yeah. Okay.
Do you want a tissue?
I'm good, thank you. I cried, but I'm okay.
I can't deal with this.
Okay. We, removing Lee's arm, we and 71% of players removed the arm.
Yeah.
We and 74% of players lost our temper with Kenny.
Oh, okay.
We and 59% of players surrendered our weapons when we were with the stranger.
That's it, huh? Wow, okay.
We and 42% of players killed the stranger, so we were in the minority.
Really?
I guess other people left him. I mean, we strangled him, right? So, like, yeah. I guess killed. Well, killed?
I don't really know how you would have.
I guess I could have stopped pressing Q.
Oh.
I was slamming on that thing real hard, but you could have. I could have not done that.
Right, okay.
And then you and 36% of players told Clem to leave Lee, which means the majority of people told that little girl to shoot us.
Oh my god.
Like 2/3 of people,
it seems. Oh my fucking god.
Approximately. Give or take.
Ugh, no. Holy shit.
God damn, man. And I knew how this was going to end. I remember watching other people play this and crying then.
I really thought that we'd be able to get back to Krista and Omid before I died.
Yep.
That's so fucked.
Yep.
That's why I was bawling, because I'm like, how's she going to survive? How's she going to... She doesn't even know where to look to find them.
Well, you gave her great advice at the end. That was the whole point.
Oh, yeah. Advice is going to go so far.
I mean, hey.
I mean... You know? It helps to a point, but this is the fucking Walking Dead. Like,
we trained her well. Are we ready to click to continue?
Is there more?
I mean, arguably, yes. There's going to be a little bit more to this episode.
Okay.
But plus, we got to talk. Like, there's some things to talk about. Okay. So, here's the information on all these people. So with Kenny, we defended his son in the drugstore.
Yeah.
We talked him down from ignoring his son's fate. Yeah. We killed his son so he didn't have to, right. And he was lost to the herd trying to save Krista.
Yeah.
For Katya, we found water for Duck when he needed it. She shot herself when faced with her son's death.
Yeah.
For Larry, you called him a racist. You tried to revive him with CPR, and Larry died in the meat locker at the library.
Yeah, right. At the dairy.
The dairy, sorry. Why did I say library?
I don't know.
Me neither. For Lily, you agreed with her when fighting at the motel. You backed her up when supplies went missing, and you left her on the side of the road. You know, with no context whatsoever, you seem like a monster here. Like, you're like, yeah, you agree like with her, you, here,
like
you back
you
her up.
Like, you build up her trust, and then you just, like, just leave her for dead.
Okay.
But... just like we said to that crazy guy, that's not the whole story, uh-huh. Right?
Well, that's what I'm saying. With no context, you sound like a monster, mm-hmm. Here. But, of course, you know, we felt, you felt, and I say you because you're the one making the decisions, not because I disagree with you, but you felt that that was the right cause of action. Right. For Omid, you left him in Clem's care before Crawford, and you were separated after they crossed the sign.
Yeah.
Ready?
Yeah.
Okay. For Ben, you defended him when he was accused of stealing, and you dropped him from the bell tower. For Carly, you saved her life at the cost of another, which was Doug.
Yeah.
And then she was killed by Lily. Okay. With Krista, you met her on her on your worst day thus far.
Yeah.
You helped her get onto the train. And you asked her and Omi to take care of Clementine, and you revealed your bite to her.
Yeah.
For Doug, you were with him when you found your brother, and he died when walkers attacked the drugstore. And for Duck, you helped save his life at Herschel's farm.
Right.
You argued that he was not bitten back in Macon.
Right.
You shot him before he could turn, and you let him be your sidekick to solve a mystery.
Yes, that's the best part. Sidekick all the way.
He was Robin.
He was the best Robin. He found some real shit.
He did. Is that it?
Yeah. I think so. That's everybody, isn't it? I mean, Herschel and the people
right,
from the dairy.
But that's not, yeah, but they weren't our companions.
Atop the crags and cliffs, the air is thin.
I'm going to go ahead and hope that this isn't copyrighted, because that's always fun.
Yay.
But that's fine.
Maybe. I guess it is.
Meet me where the snow melt flows.
I mean, I feel bad talking over this person. Oh, look, one of the concept artists was named McCabe. That was the name of the import business.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah.
Nice.
That was the sign that we walked across, was McCabe Imports, or that they walked across. We did not.
Oh, man.
Yeah, well, we've got to talk. I just don't want us to get drowned out by the singing, so I'll wait till the end.
But it's
I apologize.
Copyright. We should talk over the whole thing.
I know. But again, it's a cool
not
song.
Not that it matters. It's not like we're really making money off of this video.
No, God no. But still, and that's not the point. The point is to play a good game and enjoy it.
Exactly.
I mean, I don't mind the song. It's kind of pretty.
It's kind of nice.
Yeah. Oh, my God. So much emotion this time.
Yeah, this sucks. Fuck. And Lee's dead, so like...
Correct.
Who do we even play as in the next game?
How do you know there's a next game?
Sorry, guys. I still got a ball on my own. Oh, man.
Dave Fennoy as Lee did an amazing job. Oh, the radio voice and the stranger voice were actually different voice actors.
Were they?
According to this.
Yes, you know. That makes sense to me.
Okay.
Yeah.
Muted voices. Just beyond.
I thought it was just the same guy, like, tweaking it.
Sure.
You know?
Sure.
To create a different mood, but they used two different voice actors. That's interesting.
Yeah.
Who was Molly?
Nobody that we know.
No.
No. I thought it might have been somebody that we knew, but.
Yeah, like
it's not.
Her voice sounded.
I looked it up purposefully because I was curious. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Not anyone I recognize. This game is 8-9 years old.
Wow.
Yeah. Or 7 or 8 years old.
Cut scene.
Mm-hmm.
After the credit scene.
Yeah.
Whoa, she made it to the country.
Mm-hmm.
What is that?
Is that a rock or a zombie? Can't tell. Probably just a rock then.
I guess she didn't find Kristen or Mead.
Nope. That gun looks so big in her little tiny hands.
Yeah, it does. Be Kristen and Mead. Walk up to them. Do it. It's okay. Oh, they're coming to us? No? I can't quite tell.
I think they're walking perpendicular to us.
Yeah.
Oh, they saw her.
That's it? Fuck! God damn it. Why would you do that? That was just to piss me off. That's all that fucking was. God damn it.
Amazing. So, Amy, this is going to be a very loaded question, but what did you think? Of the game. What did you think of this game?
... No response.
Sure, sure. The timer ran down. Sorry.
It did.
Okay.
It always fucking does. God damn it.
So, did you... When did you know Lee was going to die? Or did you know that he was going to die?
I mean, when he got bit.
Yeah, as soon as he got bitten, you knew he was dead?
Yeah.
Eventually? Okay.
And then they tried to make it seem like cutting his arm off was going to do any good, and I'm like, it's so not, but I guess we can try.
Well, it took way too long. In the Walking Dead universe, if you do it quickly, it's fine.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah, well, think about, so I guess spoilers for the television show season 4, 5, 3, something like that, with Herschel. So maybe skip ahead if you don't want those spoilers. But yeah, in the TV show, they cut Herschel's leg off. His a zombie bit his Achilles, and they very quickly cut his leg off, and then he was fine.
He was fine.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool.
Yeah. So I mean, you know, as fine can be. But yeah, he was like, you know, it wasn't like the bite infected him. Yeah. But you have to do it quickly.
Yeah.
The amount of time that it took with Lee's bite was way too long.
Yeah. I wish Clem knew that. Like, I wish we were able to explain that to Clem. Like, oh, we cut my arm off because we thought maybe it would help. But we waited a while, so maybe that's the reason why it didn't work or something like that.
Well, and don't forget, we don't know. We have no idea, right? Yeah, it was just... No, because we took a gamble.
But we had time to kind of make a conclusion.
But maybe we don't. We still don't know. Yeah. And you don't. Like, again, we were trying to give her the best advice we could.
Yeah.
So.
I just don't want her to, like, think that everyone who gets bitten as soon as they get bitten just needs to get shot in the head.
Sure. You know what I mean? Like, sure. Well, and we saw that with Duck a bit. Like, he eventually needed to get shot in the head, but he was around for a while. But again, as we talked about, he was weak for so long.
Yeah.
You know?
So I'm surprised it took us this long. Like, because when we fainted the first time, I was like, hey, wait a minute. Like, Duck had all this time. But he really didn't.
No.
But then after we, like, woke back up and we're fine.
Yeah.
We did a lot of fucking shit.
A lot of physical activity, which
would speed up the infection.
Well, I was going to say, I'm not a medical professional, but I have had some first aid training. And I know for a fact that if you have some type of an injury and or a poison in your system, or if you are bleeding from a certain spot, the last thing you want to do is be performing physical activity.
Right.
Because it's going to cause your blood to flow faster. That's just how that works, because your blood is trying to get
more
oxygen to the rest of your body.
Very nasally.
More nose blowing. Your blood will flow faster to try to get oxygen to the rest of your body, but it means that any infection that has invaded into your blood is now going to be circulated faster. That's just how it works.
Right.
So that's why typically if you get like bitten with a venomous bite or something like that, you slow down, you take a break, you relax, you sometimes raise that. Well, I guess that part is slightly different, but yeah, you would try to, let your blood flow as slowly as possible to give yourself that much more time. Although at that point it is to give yourself more time to seek medical attention.
Yeah.
And in this case,
yeah, you get help is what you do. You make sure you have someone with you who can go and get some sort of a medication or get someone who knows what to do.
Right. Right. And and so in this particular case, if you get bitten, there are two ways to go about it. You either slow down so that you give yourself more time to live before the infection takes hold, and then you die and turn into a zombie.
Right.
Or you hurry the hell up to do as much as you can before you turn.
Right.
And we seem to have chosen the second.
Yeah, right. Well, we needed to save Clementine, so it was worth it.
Okay, so my question to you then is, do we... If there might be a sequel to this game,
I already said I know there is one.
Do we seek it out and play it?
Yeah.
Okay. It won't be next week.
Okay.
I'm just saying that.
Okay.
Like we've got, you know, something else will happen on this channel next week. Don't worry. It will not be the sequel to this. We will get to it eventually because we want to. I know.
I want to right now.
I know. But no, apologies. We cannot do that. But yeah, because we don't own the sequel yet. I would have to purchase it, which is obviously not a problem, but yeah, we were able to pick up this game. I was super happy when I first felt that I wanted to do this channel with you. This was one of the top games on my list.
It's really good. I can't blame you. Holy shit.
Yeah. And we talked about this a bit last week, but I I think the timers were a little frustrating.
Yeah.
Just with the time. Just with the way that we were doing this, right? If it was just one of us, right, and pressing the buttons right. or whatever,
like maybe reading to yourself and making the choice quickly in your own head
sure.
would be fine.
But that's not. But that's also a bad viewing experience. I feel like, and
absolutely
because you don't necessarily know that all of your audience got to see all three options before you snap picked one.
No, I'm just saying if you weren't recording it, you weren't doing a show, you were just playing the game by yourself,
right.
you were reading the options to yourself and quickly making a decision, maybe those timers are not too fast. Maybe.
Right.
And, in any other situation, they're way too fucking fast. Right.
And, I should have clarified. I wasn't saying that to kind of counter what you were saying.
Oh.
I'm just talking about it from a game developer standpoint.
Oh, okay.
Like, so this was from 2012, 2013, mm-hmm. where streaming wasn't as much of a thing.
Right.
Right? It was eight years ago. Mm-hmm. YouTube was, this is where I saw this game, was on YouTube. So that was, but that was kind of when that stuff was, like, somewhat newer. And so if people were making this game for a while, it wouldn't necessarily be the case that they would have had YouTube in mind.
Yeah.
Right? Or watchability of the game right. in mind. It was right. playability.
Mm-hmm.
So nowadays...
Well, let me ask you a question then
sure.
before you get to that.
Sure.
Since you watched YouTube videos of people playing this game,
mm-hmm.
did they have as much trouble as we did making those decisions and getting them in time?
So it's been like... over 5 years, so I don't remember,
you don't remember.
But yeah. I don't think so. Because again, with the nature of YouTube and not streaming, right, I really don't remember.
Okay.
I don't
I'm sorry
remember.
To interrupt.
No, not a problem at all. It's a fair question. I don't know. I feel like if this game were made today,
mm-hmm.
it would be, the timers would be a little bit slower because... I think it would give people the opportunity to read out all of the options, pick an option, or at least, like, belabor over the choice.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess that's the question, right? About game developers in 2020 or whatever year it is that you're watching this video.
Right.
Is that, do you make your game for the player who is going to just buy it and play it on their computer at home? Or are you making it for the entertainers out there who are recording it and putting it up because that is automatically further advertising for your game?
Right, right. And I think you're right. I think in 2012, they didn't have that mindset.
And who would have expected them to, right?
Right?
That would
exactly.
be a very, or at least that would be a very forward-thinking company.
Right.
Plus the fact that...
or a presumptuous company.
Plus the fact that...
Or a very hopeful company. Like, right. Oh, we'll get free advertising, right? I don't know, probably.
Plus, if you look at Telltale as a company, we have the benefit of hindsight. And I don't know too much about the story, so I don't want to say too many things about it because I don't really know. I just know that... The company was very popular for a while, especially following the release of this game.
Because it's really good.
Yes. They released a couple of more games that I'm aware of, and there may have been others that I'm not aware of. And then they went under.
Oh.
Yeah. And if I recall correctly, the news around them going under wasn't great. But again, I can't really speak to it because I don't have that information off the top of my head. I encourage anybody that is curious to Google that and try to find reputable sources. Don't just read the first thing, assume it to be true, and, you know, go with that. Find multiple sources, reputable sources for that kind of information.
Compare and contrast and kind of form your own educated guess on what actually happened in the
yeah.
situation, I suppose. Then.
Yeah. And obviously I talked about the sequel to this game. We have other Telltale games as well that we already own on Steam. In fact, I purchased those games prior to purchasing this one because I was having a little bit of trouble finding this one, but thankfully I found
really?
It. Well, because after they went under, with this being like one of their older ones, it may not have made sense to purchase this one because who do you give money to? If the company's gone, right, who makes money off of it? So,
I don't know.
it was a bit difficult to find this at first. Then I found it. I was happy that I found it.
I guess the creditors who they owed money to if the company went other.
I don't know. I really have no idea. But that also could have been, you know, something that was like in contention following the purchase or the bankruptcy of the company. You know, that like the games weren't for sale because there was contention.
Yeah, that makes sense.
In who gets the money.
Yeah.
And then once that was resolved, this is all speculation.
Right.
This is all speculation.
We're just making shit up here.
But like I said, with the sequel to this game, plus the other games that we own from Telltale, maybe if we have enough forethought and it, genuinely, if I remember, we can look up some of that stuff in between so that, you know, following playing those other games, we can formulate an opinion and then talk about it a little bit more from there.
Okay.
You didn't watch the TV show as much.
Yeah.
You watched a few episodes with me, some with your sister, I think, as well.
Yeah.
Or your dad, or whatever.
Yeah, or whatever.
I
watched bits and pieces.
Yeah. Like, I remember you watched some of the Negan stuff with me, just because Negan's so goddamn awesome.
I knew that can I give spoilers, or
I mean, just be aware, these are spoilers for the television show. We have not even seen the most recent season, the one that got goozled because of COVID-19. So we're not going to be spoiling that one. But I guess anything up till that point is somewhat fair game.
I didn't realize that was a thing. I thought the show was over already.
No.
I saw some of the episodes with Negan. I saw Glenn get killed.
Yes.
I saw Abraham get killed.
Well, that was the same episode. Yeah.
But, like, I didn't see a lot of other, like, super meaningful stuff happen.
Sure. You saw the Herschel death, though.
I did?
I thought so. Again, spoilers. Sure. Herschel got his head chopped off by the governor with Michonne's sword. You don't remember that?
I don't think I saw that.
Okay. Anyway... He was one who had a zombified head. Once his head got chopped off, it got turned into a zombie. And so he was just on the ground like...
Yeah. The last one I saw was the one with all the zombified heads on the spigots.
So good.
You know.
The spikes. Well, whatever. Yeah.
Whatever they are.
Yeah. The from the Whisperers. Yeah, whatever.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
So good.
Carl's
oh my God.
Girlfriend. And,
yeah. So good.
Who else was it?
The king and Carol's son, quote unquote, but not really. Adopted son. Yeah. There were a number of people. Yeah, it was awesome, though. Oh, my God. It was so good.
Yeah, kind of reminiscent of that barricade that we saw.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
Well, and so that was what I was going to ask, right? You're tangentially aware of the show, some bigger beats of the show that I've shown you or that you happen to have seen. What did you think of this game dropping references to the comics and or the show with Glenn and Herschel, etc.?
Yeah. Interesting. It was so drastically different from what you would think it was going to be when they made those references.
Okay.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
'Cause they made those references, but it was quick, and then they never came back to it.
Sure.
And I think it kind of lulled me into a little bit of false sense of security, thinking it was going to be more similar to the show.
Oh, okay.
But I quickly decided I didn't care because it was good.
Well, I was going to say, I mean, so...
But it almost feels like, why did they do that? Because I don't feel like they needed to.
I think it may have been just to reward hardcore fans.
Of the
comics and or the TV show. Where it's like, oh my God, it's Glenn!
How long had that stuff been around when they made this?
That's a...
Because I feel like the show probably... wasn't around too long before they made this game. But the comics had been, I feel like.
Well, probably, because they had to have all this stuff, you know, nailed down by that point.
Yeah, but this stuff wasn't in the comics. I mean, it's a different story.
Correct.
I mean, it's the same universe, but it's a different story.
Correct. Okay. So, The Walking Dead television show premiered in 2010.
Okay, so 2 years before this, essentially.
Right. And again, you don't know how long the game is being worked on.
Yeah, yeah.
And Herschel in the show wasn't introduced until season 2.
Okay.
And so you figure if it's 6 months to a year per season, that's, you know, you're getting into, you're getting close to this game by the time
yeah.
Herschel was around. But this game was canonically pre-show.
Yeah.
Because Glenn leaves us at the motel to go be in the show, essentially.
Right.
And when we see Herschel, his farm is still there. And we know that from the moment that we meet Herschel in the show, it ends with him having to leave that farm. So, yeah, interesting. It'll be, I'm interested because I actually know literal zero about the sequel to this game.
Oh.
I saw this whole game. I know nothing of the sequel.
Oh.
At all. So I'll be curious to see.
When did the sequel come out?
Of this game? I have no idea. I just wasn't, the people that I had watched who played the original, I was not watching any longer or whatever. But yeah, I don't know. Okay, let's do this one. So season two of this game came out.
Is that what they call it? They call it seasons?
Yeah.
Oh, that's weird.
Oh, it came out at the end of 2013. So soon after this one.
Soon after this.
And then season three came out.
I didn't realize they called it seasons.
Yeah. Well, they didn't for this one because they didn't necessarily know.
They didn't know that they were doing another one.
Sure. This season three came out in 2016.
Okay. And was it still Telltale at that point?
Yes. Oh, okay. Yeah. Telltale was within. Okay. And then the last season four came out in 2018.
Okay. That's a lot.
Yes.
I'm actually not surprised that the company went under then, because that's a lot of fucking work, especially when the quality is this good. That's a lot of fucking work to put in a short period of time.
Quality is this good writing-wise, art-wise? What do you mean?
Both.
Okay. All of the above?
It's clear that they put a lot of hard work and decent people into this.
And the credits were fairly long, and that's obviously not a complaint. All of the people that worked on this game deserve to have their work shown and their names and etc. The special thanks are really nice too to see that they're like thanking Robert Kirkman who created The Walking Dead, etc. But yeah, I mean, when you think about it, the comics are done in 2020 at the time that we're playing this.
Right.
The comics are done.
Right.
The this game series is done.
Okay.
Because the company has gone under, right? So there's no more of these games either.
Well, some other company could take it over.
Right? I don't know. Again, I do not have enough information.
They put out a decent number of games. Sure.
And again, I know nothing of any of the sequels.
Okay.
Two, three, or four. So I know nothing of whether there is even enough left. And I will ask politely, please don't post spoilers in the comments for us and for others for the sequels. Obviously for this game, now that it's done, right? We have played the entire thing. If for whatever reason you didn't watch the other episodes, please feel free to do so. We will, I'm sure, have the whole playlist up on the channel at this point.
Mm-hmm.
But now I would love to hear from people who played this game before watching us play it. How were things different? What did you think along the way? Because I know a lot of times we're like, hey, don't post spoilers for your fellow viewers. So I want to let you guys off the leash and be like, just let loose. If there's been things that you've been like dying to talk about, I want to give you that chance.
Right.
That's what the comments are for. Please feel free. Because at this point,
not for future games, but for this one.
Yeah, definitely not for the sequels. We will hopefully get to the sequels, especially because this game was so impactful for us.
Holy shit. My cheeks are like crusty from the tears.
Gross. Yeah, no, if I recall, you got emotional when we saw the boy up in the attic.
Yeah.
And here. Mm-hmm. What about when Duck died? No or yes? I don't recall.
Yeah.
Okay. I got emotional when Duck died.
I was surprised that they even asked the question at that point to allow Kenny to shoot Duck.
After Katya killed herself in front of him?
Yeah. Well, it wasn't really in front of Kenny.
Of course it was. They all went into the woods together.
Oh, yeah. Shit.
Yeah.
Fuck.
We were giving them time to say goodbye.
Yeah.
And then we heard the gunshot, so we ran over.
Right.
Yeah. Fuck. Because at that point, yeah, the expectation... I forgot that
he didn't come into the woods with us.
No.
And see what had happened.
No. We ran up and Kenny was just there.
Yeah.
Duck That's was leaning against the tree.
That's why I was like, you did all you could do, man. But we didn't see. We don't really know what he did.
I mean, regardless. Like, well, we don't... Well, yeah. I mean, like,
you don't say that. Well, we didn't see. We don't know what you did. You know, you don't say that to a person. But that's beside the point.
I will also say, there were moments that I feel like I recall when watching the other people play this or other person play this. I feel like I recall things going differently when they played. So if we remember when we were in the house that adjoined the mansion that we got trapped in the attic of, right? And we broke through, we had to get out onto the balcony and jump to the next roof.
Right.
We jumped, Krista and Omi jumped, Kenny jumped last. When Kenny jumped, the game made a point of zooming in on the wall where the balcony was connected. The balcony
detached.
And it's slightly detached. Right. So, what that means to me is, if Ben was still with us, that would have been one more person. And I don't mean it would have necessarily still have been in that order, but whoever was last, that might have been a problem.
Right. See, what I thought of when I saw that was, okay, now we can't go back.
Sure. Or what like I
now,
thought of.
Like, now we're going to say, let's meet back at the mansion.
Yeah.
You know, and that's the way we'll go. And we'll all get eaten by zombies.
Sure.
You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
That's what went through my head when they showed that.
Sure. And that's fair.
Like,
and
okay, now we're not going back to the house because we can't get back.
Okay. And I thought that, like, we would have had to transfer back somehow from the roof. Mm-hmm. Like, we would have had to jump from the roof to the balcony. Mm-hmm. And the first person to do that would have fallen.
Exactly, yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, that's the kind of thing, right, where I feel like I remember that going differently when I watched it the last time. But again, it's been like 5 years. Yeah, I don't remember the specifics there.
So you
don't
really
remember,
but you kind of do. Yeah. You feel like you remember.
Right. But that's what it says to me. And so, you know, I like the fact that there could have been so many different avenues for this to have gone. And I'm curious, right, because at the end of episode 4 of this, and I don't mean our episode 4, I mean the game's episode four, which was a couple of episodes ago for us at this point. At the end of that episode 4, it showed us who we went with, like who went with us or whatever.
Right.
So I'm curious how different all of these things would have been with all those different scenarios.
Were different, yeah.
So that's my question to you, Amy, not on this channel. Unless we're really either really hurting for stuff or it's something that Amy really wants to do. If you really have a desire for it, leave it in the comments. But I don't necessarily see a huge benefit in it. But I'll ask you, Amy, in general, do you think with all of that information being known about how the game has now ended, do you think this game is worth another playthrough to purposefully make different decisions?
I would be intrigued to do so.
Okay.
I would be intrigued. The thing of it is, though, that doing it that way, obviously, I'm going to have the benefit and then also the non-benefit of it not being the first time around.
Sure.
So I'll know, okay, let's make this decision instead because I want to see what happens. But whatever happens is not going to be as impactful as it was this time because it wasn't the first time around.
Okay.
Unless stuff is so drastically different that it's like, you know, it finds some other way to blow my mind,
sure.
You know?
Sure. I guess I think, you know, I find it interesting that, you know, there are people who will play a game like this and they'll try to do an all death run or an all save run. Like, do everything you can to save as many people's lives as possible.
Oh, okay.
Right? You know how different people died now. So you want to try to prevent that. Or you know how certain people died now and how you could have saved them and you don't want to. Right? You purposefully shoot Molly. You purposefully drop Ben. You purposefully don't save people here and there, whatever. Okay. Like, so I find it interesting that there could be ways that you could go about playing this game and just try to let people die as much as possible. Okay. Or the alternative, which is...
that would be very different from how we played anyway, because there was still only two people left. Sure,
and that's... right.
Far game when we tried.
Right, so that's why I say I think it's more interesting to try to save as many people as possible.
Two people left and Clementine.
Sure.
But even we died.
Sure. Yeah, exactly. So that I find interesting to see... what would have happened if you could have, like, see how many people you could have saved.
Right.
At the end of the game, how many could have been alive?
Right.
Just Krista and Omid? Like, is that a guaranteed thing? Mm-hmm. I'm curious. And so, again, like I said, I don't know that I would put it on this channel necessarily. Maybe in the future, if we're looking for something, maybe we'll revisit this. Again, if you have a desire for it, I would love to hear it from you in the comments.
Leave it in the comments. If you're just like, yes, I really want to see that, you know, leave it in the comments, because then, you know, it might change our minds that we're going to do that. But
right. And then
otherwise, probably not.
Right. And then you and I can have a conversation at that point. Again, whether we're playing it privately or publicly on camera. But we can have a conversation as to whether we want to, like, look it up and, like, see what, like,
what
have me look at it. Yes,
have done it. Yeah.
Exactly. To genuinely push this game as far as it can go of, like, let's save every person.
Right.
Right. Let's make sure that when we're done with this game, that we can, that every person will be alive.
Right.
As many people as possible will be alive at the end. But yeah, I don't know. That's an idea of mine that I think is, again, if this comes out before or after our playthrough of Super Mario 64, which I'm relatively certain it will, that's the kind of thing where that seems like completionist talk to me.
Yeah.
And that's not what I'm trying to do with this channel at this point, because I learned my lesson. I encourage you to go watch Super Mario 64. That was brutal but awesome. So yeah, I encourage you to go check out that series.
It's funny that you characterize that as brutal and not this.
Well, you know what I mean. Sure.
Walking Dead.
Sure.
We were just talking about how, like, almost everyone's dead now. This isn't brutal. What's brutal is my attempts at Super Mario 64.
That children's game, Super Mario 64. And I guess, Amy, I'll close it off with, you know, what do you think? Again, we talked about this with Life is Strange. Another shout out. You can go watch that series as well. Similar in a way to this game in that, like, your decisions have consequences and, you know, et cetera. What did you think of a game like this that just start to finish, fictional world, right? But can give you such emotion.
Yeah. I mean, what I think is that it's a great story with a great execution as well. Like I said, it's clear that they put a lot of hard work, a lot of caring people, and a lot of man hours into this.
Yeah.
You know, it was not just a thrown together kind of thing.
Sure.
They really did a good job with it.
Yeah.
And really, realistically speaking, the only critique that I have is the fact that the timers were so fast. That's
right.
The only thing that I would say. I hate the fact that they have it like this. Change that. But everything else, I mean, even the shit that I really hated, like Larry, you know, I wouldn't change it. I wouldn't change a thing.
Well, and, you know, I have to call you out a little bit.
Okay.
I have to.
Okay.
Because Larry frustrated you.
Right.
Lily frustrated you. Ben frustrated you.
Yeah.
At multiple times, at multiple points, you were like, screw it. I don't care if this person dies, etc. And yet in the moment on certain things, you were still like with Larry, you were like, he's not dead, save him. Still tried to save him.
Well, yeah, because you can't just let the guy die. Like,
But that's what I'm saying. So I find it so interesting because your initial reaction to their stupidity or their ignorance is like, oh my God, you're so goddamn dumb. Like, I can't deal with you.
Right.
Like, please just like go away and be dead,
right.
so that we don't have to deal with you anymore.
Right. And the thing of it is that it's not that I want them to be dead. It's that I don't want them making the rest of the group dead.
Sure.
Because of their stupid decisions.
That was Ben more than Larry, I would argue. But Larry, not for lack of trying on Larry's part.
Well, and not for Lily's lack of trying either. Sure. But she still ended up getting people dead.
Yep.
So, like...
Yeah. I just...
And the other thing is, too, maybe if it was a different character having to make the same types of decisions, maybe it's those types of decisions. You know what I mean? Like, maybe it's not the person who makes the decisions. Maybe it's the types of decisions...
Okay.
...that affect... You know, because... what Lily did was she took care of the food rations.
Sure.
Right? And then she freaked out because she was like, we have a fucking spy, essentially.
Well, someone's like stealing supplies.
Giving away our shit to, you know, looters.
Yeah.
For no reason. And so then she got all, like, suspicious and fucking killed somebody.
Yep.
And so I was like, fuck Lily, like, you could just not get all suspicious and not kill somebody. But, like, maybe it's the role that she was in as opposed to it being Lily. You know, because maybe if our character was that person,
sure,
maybe we would have gotten that fucking suspicious and murdered somebody as well.
Sure. Well, I mean, it's, you know, it's the...
Because at that point, we know, you know, it wasn't, well, it's just a suspicion.
Mm-hmm.
At that point, we knew somebody was giving away our shit.
Correct. It was very obvious.
You know, and what the problem was we knew it was down to two people.
Yes.
Or we thought we knew
right. It was down to two had people. Kind of collectively narrowed it down to two, yeah.
So, like, if it had been us instead of Lily, would we just have acted exactly the same way she did?
Sure.
You know?
And, well,
and gotten ourselves left behind. Right. You know what I mean? So, and I'm trying to, like... I think in the beginning, I was thinking more in terms of, like, we're in this group of survivors, basically, in this fucking pandemic. Mm-hmm. Like, we need to make it through this with the most people alive as we can.
Right.
And with caring about the group more than about ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's why I got frustrated with people like Larry and people like Ben, because Larry cared more about the fact that, well, I have a heart condition, so I can't do any work.
Yeah.
Then he cared about, well, we need to find food.
Right. Even though Mark commented correctly that the dude was like all muscle.
Right.
Right.
Yeah.
So he was physically like strong and right. So should have been more capable.
Right.
And it would have been nice to have him around in that way.
Right, but. Especially if we had medication for him. If we didn't have medication for him, then I can understand why he'd then be afraid to go out and fight walkers.
Right.
But if we had supplies, which Lily made it seem like we had supplies, then he should have been more capable than just to sit there and make a fence.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like...
Yeah.
And his attitude was such that he was such a fucking asshole to everyone for no reason other than that that's how he was before.
Sure.
And the thing that sucked was everyone else that was there understood that at that point, everyone else in the world's fucking dead.
Mm-hmm.
So it doesn't matter who you were before, right? But Larry was just still that fucking person. And it's like... If you live in a world where, you know, you're just this privileged old white guy who's, you know, just, you know, living life and doing whatever.
Right.
Then maybe you can act like that.
Right.
But when you're living in a world where everybody's a fucking zombie and gonna bite your goddamn head off.
Yeah.
And you're in a small group of people who are trying to survive, you can't be that asshole anymore.
And that's a principle that the Walking Dead IP in general has always put forth. That it was a line in the comics and it's like the minorest of spoilers. It really doesn't reveal a ton, but there were a couple of female minority characters in the comics who flat out said, like, you know, talking about racism or just lack of inclusion in general, and saying, hey, who knows? Now that the world is all different, who's to say that we're minorities anymore?
Right.
Who could know? Like, we're all, you know, and I think at that point, if I recall correctly, at that point, they were looking around a group of very diverse people.
Yeah.
And saying, like, you know, look, this is what where we are now. And so The Walking Dead kind of was always about that. Is that, like, yes, exactly your point of when you're fighting for survival, who cares who that person across from you is, right, as long as they're a good person.
Right.
Right.
Well, and I guess that kind of goes back to it, because it's still like, that's the way it should be now. You know, whether you're a privileged white guy or not, you should still just not give a shit about that stuff. But people fucking do.
Right.
And it's messed up.
Right.
But in this situation, us sitting here going, like, how could you still care about this? Because people who care about it care about it.
Yeah.
If you're a fucking racist asshole, you're still going to be a fucking racist asshole when your life is in danger.
Yeah.
You know, that doesn't change, I guess.
Yeah. And this this was, and again, I mean, a strong black male lead,
yeah,
in this game.
Yeah.
Amazing. And a black
and
male lead.
Krista was great too. She was incredible.
But a black male lead who was strong, who was capable, and yet who, I mean, I guess based on our decisions, but who had the great capacity to be kind.
Yeah.
Able to, and please don't misunderstand what I'm saying. Black people can absolutely be kind. That's not where
kind in this situation.
No, not even what I'm saying.
Oh.
I'm saying be kind in media. Be portrayed as being a kind individual.
Oh.
Like that's the kind of representation and inclusion that you want. And again, please understand where I'm coming from, right? I am a straight white guy, so I get it that, you know, I'm not necessarily the person to speak out on this. So if there are people with better answers to this than me, please shout it out. I am not in any way attempting to say that I have that I'm the authority on anything. This is how I feel about it, based on the things that I've heard from others, mixed with my own experiences, because how else can anybody say anything, right? That's just how I live my life. But I appreciated the way that Lee was portrayed in this one. That, I mean, if you want to come in here and just be as good a person as you possibly can, you have that option from start to finish. Those choices are there for you. And he was great and played. And again, you even, Amy, responded when Vernon kind of accused us of not being a good father figure. You were like, okay, well, F you too, dude. That's right. It. Done.
Well, and that's, you know, what I will say in contrast to what you're saying. I really, really had a problem with how fucking often people had to bring up that they believed that I didn't know what I was doing with Clementine.
Sure.
Because I'm sorry, just because I'm a black man who doesn't have a female at his side at every moment doesn't mean I don't know how to raise a kid. And not a single one of those people made those assumptions knowing that I wasn't already a father.
Sure. Sure. Because they...
Not a single one of them were like, are you a dad first?
I feel like one
maybe
person...
Maybe Kenny.
I was going to say, I feel like one person asked if we had kids.
Yeah, I think maybe...
One person.
Or I think it was Chuck who asked if we had kids.
Maybe.
Somebody did.
Yeah.
Somebody asked. But that was the only person who ever asked whether we were a parent before accusing us of not knowing what we were doing with Clementine.
Right.
But I think to apply context to that, I think the reason is because everybody kept on talking about that kids don't survive.
Right.
If a kid is in this universe, they end up dying,
right,
essentially, is right. I think what the game was trying to convey to us through that.
Sure. And a lot of Walking Dead talked about that as well. Like, you know,
but yeah, it really made me fucking upset that people kept on assuming that I was not going to be an adequate parental figure for her.
Sure.
Honestly.
Yeah. Yeah. It's but listen, I think that start to finish, I mean, again, first of all, I'd like to commend you, Amy, on working your way through this game. There were moments towards the end in this episode where you can probably go back and hear it, where I had to read some of those dialogue choices, and I'm like, okay, swallow the tears, just, you got to talk right now, asshole. And so I'm like, and I'm trying to push through, and the whole time you're like, it's this, right? You knew what you had to say, because at that point we are protecting this little girl,
right?
That's our job. We're trying our best, and
that was always our job.
Sure. Absolutely. And arguably any group that we were in, that was the group's job as well.
Yeah.
I mean, it was to protect everyone.
Right.
But that kind of understanding that, like, the kids need to come first.
Right. And that's why the decisions that I made were the decisions that I made. That's why I saved Duck.
Yeah.
Instead of
Herschel's son.
Yeah. That's why I hated Ben after he didn't take care of Clementine.
And Chuck did. Chuck went over and risked, and I guess gave his life to save her in that respect. So yeah,
and Chuck also helped us, figure out how to properly equip Clementine.
Yeah, fix her hair, give her a teacher to shoot.
For surviving in this world.
Yeah. He was great for that. I think that this game,
and maybe his ability to do that partially came from having a child with him at some point and having to do that himself, or having to see one of the other group members that he had with him do that.
Sure.
And then ultimately they still passed, but. He was at least able to make those determinations in a way that our character was not.
Yeah. I love that there is so much discussion to be had about this game, because it just shows another layer, right? Mm-hmm. Because this isn't gameplay. First of all, I was going to say, I hope everybody is okay with this portion of these videos. I really think it's important to analyze games like this when we're done with them, to talk about them, to talk about the impact that they've had on us, to talk about the art and the decisions that the writers and the game makers and the game developers have made, because it's important. I think it's a cool thing. And so I hope it's for you as a viewer that it is something that you can still enjoy, and then it's not like boring as hell. And again, I'm always welcome to constructive criticism, feedback, etc. You know, should this have been its own episode, kind of a thing, or is it okay? But we've all been sitting here just staring at this blank screen while having this discussion, because I think it's an important discussion. And to talk about such a great game, because if it was a bad game, first of all, we wouldn't have played it all the way through to the end, right? That's just how we do things on this channel, right? If it's a bad game, but if we are not enjoying our experience with the game, then we can say, you know what? We played it. This is the end of it, because this is as far as we can see ourselves going, or as far as we can stomach with it.
Right.
So we're going to stop now. And we can still analyze it at that point and be like, why are we stopping? What are we feeling, etc. But for this game, because we played it all the way through, the characters and the motivations of those characters, etc., really warrants this kind of discussion, I feel. Mm-hmm. And so I think if we had just played the game start to finish, oh, Lee's dead, there's Clementine, she sees two people, whoop, there's the sequel, maybe we'll play the sequel, thanks for watching.
Right.
That's not as important to us. The gameplay was great and etc., but the nature of the game also doesn't really lend itself to being analyzed while you're playing it.
Yeah, because you don't have time.
Right, which again is super flavorful.
Yeah.
Right, because you don't have time. There's zombies everywhere.
You can't even make a simple decision in time.
Correct. So, and so that I appreciate, but it also means that, you know, to have an in-depth discussion means we got to stop here and talk for a fair length of time about it. So
And we didn't really do that between episodes of this show.
No. Well, a little, but not a lot. You're right.
Slightly.
You're right.
But I think we were saving it up because we wanted it to be with you guys. We wanted the discussion to have have your feedback as well.
And also,
so we want to hear from you in the comments.
Yeah.
How you feel about all of this.
Definitely.
We, you know, we want the other half of that conversation.
Yeah. Please keep it going in the comments again with us and with your fellow viewers. Any and all opinions that you have. I also have to say, for me personally, right, talking about not talking about it in between episodes or you know, at the end of each episode or whatever.
Yeah.
I despise having conversations that end with like, well, we'll have to wait and see. Like, that frustrates the crap out of me, because it's like, no, like, let's analyze. Like, we can't say like, well, is Kenny going to be redeemed? We'll have to wait and see. You know, that kind of thing.
Right.
Like, I don't like that. I prefer having the finality of it and knowing, and so being able to have that discussion. So it does kind of end load this stuff. I don't know that that's really the right word, but but like, pack it all on at the end. But I was thinking, you know, hopefully I remembered to name it this, because who knows how long it's going to be. But I feel like this is our finale episode of this show, and it's where we did a lot of analysis. So it's like, you know, finalysis.
Gross.
Wow. The blank stare that Amy gave me when I said that. All right, fine.
That's gross. I mean, you can name it that because I won't be there to watch you do it, so I won't be able to stop you, but it's still gross.
Leave it in the comments. Finalysis, good or bad? So yeah, as
it'll
I said.
It'll still be after you've done it.
Yeah. I mean, I can still change the title. Like, the title change is very simple.
Fine.
But yeah, I'd love people's opinions on finalysis. Is it a thing, or should it never, ever, ever be a thing?
Y'all know my opinion.
So thank you all so very much for watching. I really do hope everybody enjoyed any and all of this series that you watched. Genuinely, as we have both said, we think it warrants a larger discussion, and we really would love to hear from you in the comments.
Yes.
The comment section is not just a place to write the word first. You know, keep talking. Keep
Come
telling us what
us.
You think.
Come at us
yeah.
with whatever you got.
Bring it.
You know, we'll jab back.
I wasn't looking for an argument. No, anyway.
it can be an argument. It can be, you know, it can be anything.
I'm just messing.
You know.
But yeah, so that is it. That is the end of this series. I really enjoyed myself. Amy, thoughts?
I mean, this was incredible. I really don't know how else to describe it.
And yet, if you were to say how you felt about the television show prior to this, would you have even come close to that kind of a description about the show versus this game?
Oh, sure.
Really?
Yeah.
You liked the show?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry. I just know that you didn't watch a lot of it. And if I recall correctly, there were...
But I think it's a pretty incredible show.
Okay. All right. Good.
I'm not a zombie movie fan. Genre fan.
Sure.
Like, that's just, you know, that gets old for me, you know?
And it's, there is definitely an argument to be made, in my opinion, about how played out zombies are presently.
Right.
It's 2020. Mm-hmm. I get it. This was back 2012, 2013, so maybe.
Right.
But.
I mean, the first zombie movie I ever saw, the first couple of zombie movies I ever saw, especially if they were pretty different from one another, they were cool because it was a concept I was unfamiliar with.
Sure.
You know, but being familiar with it, it gets a bit old.
Yeah.
But that's why this game is good, because this game isn't kill zombies. This game is have thoughtful, meaningful interactions with people. And try to keep them alive, try to stay alive in this terrible situation.
Sure.
And the terrible situation just happens to be zombies. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's a much deeper concept.
Sure.
Than shooting zombies.
Right. Yeah. So, I like I said, I cannot tell you what is going to be in this time slot next week, but there will be something next week. The best way to find out what it is and when it comes out is to hit that subscribe button down below.
Yes.
Please. And then ring that bell so that you will get notified.
Ding.
When, nice.
For whom the bell tolls.
Nice. So that you will find out when all of our videos come out, like I said, whatever the next series is, as well as the continuation of the rest of the series that are going on this channel. So, for now, from us here at the Geek for All family of channels, I have been Joe.
And I'm Amy.
Thank you all genuinely so very much. We would really love to hear from you down below, as we said. And, as we always say, in whichever video of ours you watch next, we will see you all next time. Thanks so much, everybody.